Ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to explore one more set of tricky JavaScript interview questions. I've already created, I believe, 3 tutorials on this. I'll provide a link at the end so you can watch the others. You don't have to watch those to watch this, you know, they're all independent, but they're all tricky in their own ways. So what is tricky really means here? The answer to these questions are never what you expect them to be. Well, that's what tricky. So you think it's something and then it's something else, right? So interviewer would ask you this kind of questions to see if you're paying attention, or just if you look at the question and answer it right away, most probably it's going to be a wrong answer because you did not look at the trick inside. And you can also ask your friends if they think they are JavaScript hotshots and confuse them as well. And wait for the ultimate teaser at the end of it. And welcome to Texi Tutorials. All right, so let's get started. So my first question is this. What is the answer to console.log this? Okay, so I'm not gonna explain anything here. You need to understand this by yourself. So what I would suggest is you could pause the video, understand the question, come up with an answer, and then start the video again to see if your answer matches with mine. And also, you need to explain why you came up with an answer. Just coming up with an answer doesn't really solve it, right? Okay, so the answer to this question is, let's look at it. If I run this, I would get -1. And why? So let's understand this. So first we have an array, x, with 3 elements, 1, 2, and 3, right? So it has 3 indexes, 0, 1, and 2, where you have value 1, 2, and 3. Then I add another element at the index -1. And then I'm trying to console log. I'm trying to find out first inside what's the value of this element. So what is x.index of 10,000 means? Index of in JavaScript means find this inside in an array. Find this value inside an array. So is there a value which is 10,000 inside the array? The answer is no. So what happens when you don't have the value? Then you get -1. So technically, this becomes -1. So this was a trick, right? Now what is the answer to this? -1. We already know this. This is a negative index, so you have to be careful. In JavaScript, negative index doesn't really work as we expect it to be, and you need to understand how it works, right? I have a tutorial on a negative index. I'll provide a link here so you can understand overall how it works. All right, so now we come to our second question. This is a simpler one, and now it's gonna get tough after this one, okay? But it's an important one. This is, a lot of people would ask this. It's a tricky one. A lot of you probably know already answer to this, and so this is like a confident booster before I ask you a big tricky one. Okay, so what is an answer to this? I have an array and I'm sorting it. So what would be the resultant array? Let's say if I console log here. Again, pause the video, think about it, and then tell you the answer. All right, so let's look at what the answer is. If I run this, the answer is 1, 15, 2, 30, 45, 5, and 7. Now, a lot of people would have expected that it should have been, you know, it should sort in numbers, right? Because these are numbers, not a string. But JavaScript, unfortunately, would not think them as a number, and they just sort them as a string. Now, what is the solution to it? If I really want to sort this number into ascending order or descending order, what is the solution to it? Now just think about it and I'll give you the answer. So the solution is I can pass a callback function here. So I'll just say A and B here. And here, all I have to do is return A less than B. When I do this, it will sort it in descending order, So now if I run this, I will get 45 plus first, then 30, 15. And now it's really sorting as number because I'm telling it when it's comparing, rather than comparing as strings, compare them as a number because I'm using the less than operator. If I change it to a greater than operator and run it, now it's sorting in ascending order. So this is how you can sort numbers. Now this was a simpler one. Now let's go to a tough one. All right, so our next question. Here I have for console log. So I have a value of I. I haven't defined it yet, but it's something, okay? And what I'm doing is I multiply by I plus one, I minus one, and I divide by I. And what I want in expected results, this should be zero, this should be one, this should be minus one, and this should be one. So if I want this desired result, what should be the I? What should be the value of I? Again, pause the video, come up with an answer, and we'll tell you it. Answer to this is pretty easy. If I have a zero, then zero plus one is one, zero minus one is minus one, and zero multiplied by zero is zero. However, zero divided by zero would be infinite, right? So this doesn't really work. So what kind of number would give me this result? Well, there is one number in JavaScript that is equipped to do that. And that is inside a number library, and it's called min value. What is a min value? Min value is the smallest number in JavaScript. If I print it, let's say console log I, let's run this. So it's quite small and it's almost x like a zero. Okay, that's why when I multiply itself, it gives me zero because it behaves, in most cases, behaves like a zero. So that's why zero plus one, zero minus one. And when you divide a small number by a small number, you get one because it's not a zero. That's why you don't get infinite here. That's why you get the desired result. So this is the one that if you ask a friend or coworker who thinks that they know JavaScript, this will tease their brain a little bit. Now, are you curious if I change this min value to max value, what would happen? Let's just do it and see what really happens, right? The curiosity should be there if you're a programmer so that you can explore all the possibilities. So if I change this to max value, again, max value is quite big, as you can see. And if I multiply this max value by max value, as expected, it should give you infinity. Largest number multiplied by largest number, it has to be bigger than largest number. And since largest number is this, anything more than that should be infinity, right? So that's what it is. Adding one should not make much difference. And dividing a number to a number which is non-zero should be one. This is, so you can ask another question like this. What's the answer to this? Which numbers multiplies to zero and divides to one? And that should be both min value and max value. All right, so next teaser. This is a simpler one, I should say. What should this X print? Again, pause the video, think about it, and we can tell you the answer after. All right, so let's look at it. If I run this, it gives me 1, 2, 34, 5, and 6. And that is because plus operates on strings and numbers. So what it does, if it's not a string or number, it would try to convert into them. So since you cannot convert this into a number, it would convert to a string. When I convert to a string, it would give me 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6 with commas in between, and then it concats them, right? So that's why you get 34, because the last number was 3 and the first number here is 4. If I want to merge this two array, I should have done something like this, and that should give me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as an array. So now if I run this, I would get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as an array. So if I convert, and I can convert to string. I believe if I do this, then it should convert to string like this. Okay. This here, you don't get that's 34, you get 3 and 4. If you want to know more about spread operators, I have a tutorial on it. I'll provide a link here so you can understand them better. All right, so the next brain teaser. What is the answer to this? Now I have 18 fives here. And so what's the answer to this? Again, pause the video and think about it. All right, let's look at it. So if I run this, I would get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16 numbers, and then I have 2 zeros. Why is that? It just doesn't make sense, right? Well, the reason is, in JavaScript, there is a maximum integer value, which is called max safe integer. So if I print this, let's do that. So if I console log number dot max safe. So it prints this number. So this is the maximum allowed integer in JavaScript. You cannot go beyond it. And if you do, then it will basically put zeros after that. So that's what's happening here. And you can see here, it's 16 digit. So beyond 16 digit, if you have anything, it would convert them into zeros because it won't allow this number. All right, so the next one here. So what is the answer to this? What would be A and B here? So pause the video and think about it. All right, so let's first run it and see what it prints. So if I run it, well, it gives me A is not defined, but let's say if I print B first and then A, then it would give me 100 for B and error for A. So let's try to understand what's going on here. So this right here is called iffy. It's called immediately invoked function expression, which is a function that runs right away. And when I do something like this, this creates like a block. And let, it has a block scope, which means anything defined with let would not exist outside this block, right? So A and B are defined using let. So it should not exist outside. However, B exists, but A doesn't, which means A is behaving correctly, B isn't. And you can see why it's happening, because in JavaScript, if you do A, let A equal to B equal to 100, B is not defined using let keyword. So it's not like let A and let B. Because B is not defined using let keyword, it automatically becomes global. And when it becomes global, you can access it anywhere. And that's why you can get B outside the scope here. So to fix it, you should always do this. One way to do it is, that should solve it. If I run it now, A and B should not exist. But if I have it inside, and run it, they would both give me 100. So this is the reason why. All right, so that comes to our last one now. N, not a number, equal to not a number. What should it get and why? Now this is a homework. I'm not gonna give you answer to this. So what I want you to do is message me with an answer and let me know exactly why it's happening. But don't read other people's comment because you might find out. So let me know why it's happening. So hey guys, so by the way, this is a playlist on my channel, which is all about JavaScript interview questions. If you really like this tutorial, then you might enjoy this playlist. start with the first one. I have part one and two, which is top 10 JavaScript interview questions. These are not tricky ones, but the typical JavaScript interview questions. Similarly, I have CSS ones, and then starts the weird one. And don't forget to share this video with your friends and your colleagues, at least some of those who think that they know JavaScript very well, and they might enjoy the humor as well. And I hope you enjoy this video, and if you did, please like. It just takes a few seconds, just like, click like. Subscribe and provide a nice comment, and you can help this channel via Patreon, or you can translate this video for me. I'll provide a link in the description on how to translate in your native language. I really appreciate it, and thank you.